My name is Kate and this is Millie.
Hello.
And we're walking down to the end of the pier right now because I don't know if you've heard, but there's a new ride going on here. I mean, we're heading down to the classic of the pier, the Twister, to meet Brendan, who's introduced a VR element to the ride. And he's going to tell us a bit more about that. So Brendan, can you tell me what's going on today?
Well, today is our first day of opening on the Twister Fairground ride, which is actually, it celebrates its 80th anniversary this year as, in, as a ride design. It's very old, but it's still very popular. But I've added VR to it and giving punters an incredibly different, exciting experience on the ride.
So what made you think to add virtual reality to this ride on the pier?
My background originally was as an aeronautical engineer, and understanding the G-forces on a body, something that really fascinates me. In fact, actually, I originally wanted to be a doctor, a medical doctor, surgeon, and I'm really interested in human physiology, the way the brain works. And from there, I started to, as a designer, retrained as a designer, started making interactive exhibits, and then started working for theme parks. And I realized there's a relationship between engineering and people's emotional experience, people's thrill. And it's when I was first introduced to VR in 2016 that I realized the link there with visual illusion, being able to feed the brain with images that aren't necessarily reality, that I could make people believe that they're doing all sorts of incredible things. And there's an old fairground ride called the Haunted Swing, which is way back, it's 100 years old. No, well, it was this mechanical swing, you'd swing backwards and forwards, and the room would go in the opposite direction. And it would make people feel that they were swinging much further than they were. So, very cheap ride, but people came off going, oh my God, I can't believe I've just done that. And I thought, maybe we could do this with other fairground rides, and that's what we're doing today.
Wow, that's amazing. That's such a good idea, because it sounds like you're almost like massively boosting someone's experience, but they're still, I mean, you might have someone going on that's just having the same experience as before. They haven't got the virtual reality headset, but someone else is having a totally different experience, probably like 10 times more exciting just from wearing something on their head. It's so crazy to try and comprehend.
Well, that's it. So the way we're operating is we've got this traditional ride, the Twister, which is circles within circles, makes you feel like you're zooming across really fast, then getting squeezed across the side, then zooming across the other side. That's just the normal ride. We take those forces. So if you hire one of our headsets and put it on, in our world, you feel that you're going, but then you're being flown up into the air. And so you get this incredible sense of height. You're looking down. People start screaming when they look down. But then you realize you're going up into the heavens, and then a whole new crazy world appears above you. A lot of people are a little bit worried about putting a headset on. It really feels just like wearing skiing goggles, and once you're looking inside, you can see a whole new world. So it feels very large, very expansive. Now, we're asking people to ride without a mask if they feel comfortable, and that's mainly because, you know, with masks, it blows up the air inside. And so that puts a kind of, what we've been looking at, a higher viral loading in the headset. But they're all clean to NHS standards anyway. So people who are happy to ride without masks, we encourage them to do so. If you do want to ride with a mask, still absolutely fine. So let's put it on, have a spin, see what you think.
All right, perfect, can't wait. Oh, oh wow, okay, hello. Whoa, Jesus Christ.
Oh, here we are in the top world.
Oh my God, it's an alternate reality. Oh, wow. Oh, God, and we sink back down to earth. So that was amazing. I can't believe how the motion lined up with the video like that. I felt like I was in a completely different world.
Well, that is absolutely the trick behind all this, is that the movement, there is no latency. That's what they call it in the industry. But the movement and the visuals are absolutely synced up. And that's one of the worst things that can give motion sickness in VR. But we don't get it, because that's the thing that we've nailed.
Absolutely, you have. No, I don't feel at all sick. I just feel like I took off the goggles and I was back on Earth somehow. No, and the visuals were so unique as well. I was expecting, I mean, I don't know what I was expecting, but it felt like a dream world, and it felt like it could have been days, I don't know.
Well, we need to bring all the crew on.
Yes, absolutely.
All the crew, come on, come on.
Well, thank you so much.